Now, in this video, we'll look at the effect of slip on the velocity ratio. Okay, so this is the same diagram as in the previous video. So let us say that the slip in between the belt and the driver is S1%, where slip is given in percentage, and the slip between the belt and the driven is S2%. Okay, so the linear velocity without slip is V1 and V2. We know this. Alright, so the velocity between the belt and the driver, considering the slip, would be, so the linear velocity between belt and pulley, or I would say driver in this case, not pulley, driver. Okay, so V1 is coming in, but there is a reduction of S1 percentage of the value of V1. So I can say this will be V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100. So this is the velocity which is actually passing over this driver, not V1, because there is a certain amount of destruction of that velocity due to the slip. Okay, now this velocity is coming out of the driver and is going into the driven pulley. So driven pulley, we know is that it has a velocity V2. So the linear pulley, linear velocity between the belt and driven pulley. Okay, this is V2. But V2 is not equal to V1 now in this case, because this much is entering the, or you can say this much velocity is being brought by the belt to the driven pulley. So I would say this is equal to V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100. Now there is a certain amount of slip in between the driven pulley and the belt. Okay, so this will also reduce. So there is a reduction of S2% of whatever the whatever velocity is coming in. So that is V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100. So this much is coming in, still there is a reduction of S2% of this value. Okay, so I can take V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100 common, and that would be V2. Okay, and you would be left with 1 minus S2 by 100. Okay, so you can multiply these two. You will have V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100 minus S2 by 100 plus S1 S2 upon 10,000. Okay, you can easily choose to ignore this, no need. Just left with this. This would be V1 into, you can take minus common, and you will have 1 minus S1 plus S2 upon 100. Now S1 plus S2 is the total slip. You can just add these two percentage values, and that will be the total slip in percentage for the entire system. So your V2 will now become V1 into 1 minus S upon 100, where the value of S is S1 plus S2. Alright, so this is how we, you know, recognize or compensate for the effect of slip in between the belt and the pulleys. Alright, so I hope you got this mathematical analysis. Now, let's move on to the next video and derive a relationship between the length of the belt which passes over this configuration of pulley. That is, this is an open belt arrangement. Okay, and there is one more arrangement, that is the cross belt. Cross belt. Okay, so we'll talk about the open belt and the length of the belt over this pulley arrangement in the next video.